activated Vinash Narasimha Swami Maharaj 给我们讲解今天的大伯加瓦谈早课，请聆听 Hare Krishna。
Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschachate Shatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So in this final section of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, we're hearing Parikshit Maharaj described the glories of Vrindavan to his mother Uttara.
现在我们已经讲到了大伯加瓦谈中的古书的最后一部分了。现在我们聆听到的是 Parikshit Maharaj 带给他的母亲 Uttara 形容 Vrindavan 的荣耀。
And Parikshit Maharaj is describing how the gopis of Vrindavan glorify the different features of Vrindavan.
现在呢 ，Parikshit 母亲，勾品们、牧牛姑娘们，他们正在荣耀Vrindavan的各个景色。
We heard how the gopis first of all glorified the clouds which were over Vrindavan. They said they're great devotees.
牧牛姑娘首先在荣耀。Vrindavan 天空当中的云朵，他们说一些云朵全部都是伟大的奉献者。
And then they glorified the different rivers which flow through Vrindavan.
牧牛姑娘第二个荣耀的是 Vrindavan 境内的各条河流。
And now today we're going to begin by hearing how the gopis glorify the different trees and creepers in the forests of Vrindavan.
今天呢，我们将听到牧牛姑娘是如何形容温达文森林当中的各式各样的树木和爬藤。
So the trees and the creepers in Vrindavan, they're full of fruits and flowers, and they're showing how Lord Vishnu is within their heart.
森林当中的这些树木都结满了鲜花，盛开着鲜花，结满了累累的树果。牧牛姑娘就形容说，他们 Vishnu 就在他们心间。
And the branches are full because they're full of fruits and flowers, so the branches bend due to the weight.
因为这些树枝上都挂着累累的硕果，还盛开着朵朵鲜花，所以呢，它们都弯下了它们的枝条，垂到了人们的腰间。
But at the same time, they poured down a sweet sap. Sap it means like a liquid which comes from the trees, and so they're giving this sweet sap.Due to their ecstasy of love of Krishna.
由于对 Krishna 的狂喜的爱，所以他们，从他们的体内都流出了这些甜美的汁液。
So, these trees and plants in the forest, they're greater than the clouds and greater than the rivers. because they're actually sentient beings. They have, you know, they have their individuality. And these trees and creepers, the gopis consider them to be very fortunate because they're able to associate with Krishna during the day, because Krishna will bring the cows into the forest in the day, so they can see Krishna in the daytime. So when the gopis glorify the trees in this way, they feel solace, they feel some comfort from the pain of being separated from Krishna. So when we were describing about the river, how the rivers are great devotees, we talked about how Krishna plays the flute and how it brings ecstasy to the rivers. In the same way, when the trees and the creepers hear the sound of Krishna's flute, they also become ecstatic. Although the flute is actually meant for the cows, it's not meant for the trees and the creepers, but the trees and creepers of Vrindavan are very special. And when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute, that's when the sap which comes from these trees, it flows down when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute. It's like this, they're able to see Krishna everywhere. They see him in their hearts and they see him outside also. And although Lord Vishnu comes in many, he has many different forms, Lord Vishnu's Anantarup, he has many, many forms, but these trees and plants, they see him in one form, who submits himself to the control of pure devotion.
You mean the trees, commit themselves to the devotion?
Yeah, you know? Yeah.
虽然维什努他有无穷尽的形象，他是阿难塔rupa，但是对于这些树木们，他们看到的只是维什努的一个形象，因为他们自己内心都怀着一种特殊的痛爱心。But
we mean also that Krishna is also controlled by pure devotion.
Krishna他是被纯粹的奉爱所控制的。
Is controlled by the pure love of these trees and creepers in Vrindavan forest.
So
the creepers will try to hide that they are seeing Krishna, just like somebody may try to hide that they are seeing treasure, some secret treasure, so they may not want people to know. So the same way the creepers try to hide that they see Krishna.
他们可能是的，the creepers hide their seeing. They try to hide that they can see Krishna.
They don't want everybody to know that they can see Krishna.
Okay. 这些爬虫们，虽然他们目睹着Krishna，但是他们努力的掩藏这一事实，就是他们见到了主Krishna.
But because they have so much love for Krishna, everybody can see that Krishna is in their heart.
虽然这些树木爬藤，他们是如此的，但是因为他们如此的深爱Krishna，每一个人都能看出他们在内心见证着Krishna.
Externally, the creepers and trees are very rich because they have many flowers and fruits, and their branches bend low.
从外在的看，这些爬藤们，它们都是特别富有的，因为它们结满了鲜花和果实，所以它们弯曲着它们的树枝。
But they bend low not only from the weight of the fruit and flowers, but also from their humility, because they're very humble. So they want to show their good qualities.
他们之所以弯垂着枝头，不仅仅是由于这个鲜花果实的重量，还有一个原因是因为他们谦卑，他们拥有美好的品质。Right, they're
very pious and they have spiritual knowledge, and that's why they're able to show these good qualities.
他们非常虔诚，他们拥有灵性的知识，所以。
So both the gross and the subtle bodies of the trees and creepers, they're showing signs of ecstasy, transcendental ecstasy. So this shows they have the deepest wealth. They have the wealth of pure devotion. So the creepers are like wives because they embrace the trees. So the trees are like the husbands of the creepers. And they all have these symptoms, both externally and internally. They have this wealth of love of Krishna. So the gopis mentioned the creepers before the trees because the creepers are feminine, and we always say like Radha Krishna, Sita Rama, the woman's name comes first and then the man's. So they say the creepers and the trees, the creepers are feminine.
牧牛姑娘们，她们在提到大树前，先赞扬了这些爬藤，因为爬藤被认为是阴性的，阴性能量，就好像我们念诵 Radha Krishna Sita Ram 都是把 Radha 和 Sita 放在前面。So
the creepers and trees, they resemble Krishna's devotees, just like the devotees are rich with the fruit of wealth and beauty and influence. So the trees, the creepers and the trees are like that.
些树木和爬藤，他们都是给他奉献者，然后他们，他们的，他们拥有这些美丽、富裕的影响力，一种这样的财富。
And the trees, the creepers in the trees, they have flowers. The flowers are just like children, just like the devotees have their families. So the trees also have their families.
像奉献者们有自己的家人，同样的，这些树木爬藤也有自己的家人。那有自己的孩子，那就是他们藤上的鲜花。
And Krishna's devotees are rich because they have the Vedas, which are just like flowers.
Krishna 的奉献者，所以他们是富裕的，因为他们拥有韦达经的知识。韦达经就好像是花朵。
The Vedas offer rewards. They offer different. Fulfill different material desires which we may have. And so people study the Vedas and perform Vedic sacrifice, they enjoy the fruits, material enjoyment in this life and the next.But these devotees are always humble, they always bow down before the Lord, and they have very pure qualities, and their family members will show these qualities as well.
但是这些奉献者，他们都是谦卑的，他们会顶拜主，他们展示出纯洁无瑕的品质，他们的家人也会展示出同样的品质。
So devotees of the Lord of Krishna will always try to keep Krishna or Vishnu hidden in their hearts. Just like a housewife, she may have another lover, except a different man, but she's very careful.To keep the man in her heart and not to let her husband know. But Krishna or Vishnu is so, he pervades everything. So the working of the senses of the devotees cannot keep Krishna from coming, shining, from appearing, because he's everywhere and everything.So the devotees are trying to hide him, but still Krishna will appear.
Krishna 和 Vishnu 他们是遍透一切的，奉献者们他们努力的在克制他们的工作感官，他们不让他们内心的 Krishna Vishnu 就熠熠发光，但是他们却无法隐藏这一点。
And this happens especially when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute. It causes eruptions in their body, and they begin to shed tears and show all the signs of ecstasy.
尤其是当奉献者听到 Krishna 笛音的时候，他们就会起鸡皮疙瘩，然后流下泪水。
Of course, devotees are very careful. They don't want to show their love for Krishna to everyone and anyone. They try to keep it hidden.
奉献者们会小心翼翼地不炫耀他们的这种狂喜。
If people see everyone, if people see devotees with ecstatic love, then people may take it to be something very cheap and they may imitate it. But sometimes the ecstasy is so great, it just comes in their body and they can't control it and they can't hide it. So this is how the gopis are singing. This is different. We heard the gopis sing earlier. They were singing and when they were looking for Krishna, they were feeling separation from Krishna. But this is a different kind of song which they're singing now. Before, they were feeling very unfortunate because Krishna had left them and they didn't know where to find him. They were looking everywhere for him. But now, at this time, they're trying to come to pull himself above the misery of being separated from Krishna. Yeah, because they know Krishna is going into the forest during the daytime and they can't go, they have to stay back, they have duties to do. So they sing these kind of songs about Krishna and in this way they feel great happiness. Yeah, although they felt pain of separation from Krishna, but by singing about his pastimes, they were able to keep their minds fixed on him. And so they became happy even during the day. Whenever Krishna would go to the forest, the minds of the gopis would run after him. And although the gopis were very sad, but still they spent their days singing of his pastimes, and in this way they became happy. So the gopis, they're praising the tree, the creepers and the trees of Vrindavan. So they mean to say, if even plant life has such deep love of Krishna, how can we be expected to tolerate the pain of being separated from him? So the songs of the gopis, they help them to find relief from their pain and being separated from Krishna. But these songs which they're singing, they're not just some pain, not just some painful lamentation, but it's their ecstatic love for Krishna.
现在牧牛姑娘她们所吟唱的歌曲是她们内心的痛苦可以缓解，不那么感受到跟Krishna的分离了。但是这些歌曲并不是一种痛苦的呻吟，而是对Krishna的爱的狂喜的表达。
Or we can understand it that the hearts of the gopis are burning incessantly in the fire of love of Krishna. So they never really experience a moment's happiness because they're feeling so much pain of separation.
他们一刻也体验不到快乐。All right. So
then the gopis begin to glorify after the creepers and the trees. The next feature of Vrindavan they're going to speak about are the bees, and they say these bees must all be great sages and they must be very great devotees of Krishna, because they are worshipping him, they follow him along everywhere he goes, and they're chanting his glories. So the gopis say to the bees, although you've disguised yourself within the forest, although Krishna has disguised himself within the forest, these bees, they don't want to give him up because they know Krishna is their worshipable Lord.
就说虽然Krishna把自己掩藏在Vrindavan的森林当中，但是这些蜜蜂们，他们却不会放弃Krishna，他们在荣耀着、崇拜着。So
we heard about the non-moving creatures like the trees and the creepers, but now we're going to hear about this is about the bees, and that not only bees but insects and bugs and worms, you know, they can move. They're a higher form of life than the creepers and trees.
昆虫、爬虫、蠕虫，它们是比那些不动的生物更高级的生命形式。So
Lord Krishna himself, he praised the bees, that when the bees were following Lord Balaram, Lord Krishna praised the bees, and he said they're great devotees. They said wherever Balaram goes, these bees follow him, so they must be great devotees.
本人亲口在赞扬着这些蜜蜂，因为他们跟随着环绕着主巴拉拉，所以他们一定都是伟大的奉献者，因为他们在追随主巴拉拉。And
just as is true for Balaram, it must also be true for Krishna, because the bees, they never stop chanting Krishna's glories, and they're like Krishna's glories are like a holy places, and they give purification, they help people to come to the spiritual platform by hearing about Krishna's glories. So Krishna's glories are just like a very merciful spiritual master, because the very merciful spiritual master, he can deliver anyone, even a person who's not really qualified to be delivered, but this by the mercy of a spiritual teacher, he can be delivered. So these bees are like, or Krishna's glories are like that. And everyone who comes in contact with the glories of Lord Krishna, but then they will awaken spiritual knowledge and pure devotion. So the bees that follow Krishna are great sages, but they're not sages like impersonalists. They're not like the impersonalists, they're like Krishna's devotees. And Krishna's devotees, they're the most elevated, because although Krishna hides himself in the forest, these devotees, they never stop following Krishna. So to join Krishna in the forest, these devotees, sometimes they will disguise themselves as bees, and they'll take the opportunity to worship Krishna by always singing his song.
为了加入森林当中的 Krishna， 奉献者们把自己就变成了这些蜜蜂们，趁此机会来荣耀 Krishna， 唱颂他的荣耀。
So Lord Krishna glorified Lord Balaram. He described him as the original supreme person. So if Balaram is the original supreme person, then the bees, which are always with Krishna, they are the original servants. They are the original eternal servants of Krishna.
Krishna荣耀Balarama是原初的至尊之人。那么那些跟Krishna在一起的蜜蜂们
And they always know how to worship Krishna in the proper way according to his pastimes. So Lord Krishna addresses Balaram as being without sin. The Lord Balaram he doesn't have any sinful reactions.
Krishna就 对，鲁巴拉拉玛说，说他是没有罪恶的，没有任何罪恶反应。
And Krishna is also, of course, Krishna is also without sin. And so the bees are never able to leave Krishna and Balaram. They always worship them in every situation.
Krishna 当然也是无罪的，所以这些蜜蜂们，他们永远都离不开 Krishna Balarama， 在任何情况下都在崇拜着他们。
And they don't worry about making any offenses to them because they assure that by their devotional service will protect them from any reactions. So these bees, they are better.They're better devotees than these sages because the bees never stop singing Krishna's glory. But the sages, sometimes they become silent when they're in their ecstasy. Sometimes they'll chant, but other times they'll be silent. But Krishna, the bees, they never stop chanting Krishna's glories.
这些蜜蜂们是比圣人更好的奉献者们，因为他们从来不会停止去荣耀 Krishna， 而那些圣人们，他们在狂喜当中有时候会保持沉默。
Just like the Muni, great Vaishnava Munis, they're always looking for Krishna when Krishna's hiding in the forest. So these bees are like these great Vaishnava Munis.So although Krishna's pastimes are difficult to understand and it's very difficult to get to do service for Krishna, but the Vaishnava, the real devotee, will never give up Krishna. They will keep trying.To do something to serve Krishna.
虽然 Krishna 消失光难以理解，而且对，很难去服务 Krishna， 但是 Vaishnava 永远不会放弃 Krishna， 永远会努力去服务 Krishna.
And they always sing about the glories of Krishna, and they're always trying to preach about the glories of Krishna to others.
他们永远的、永恒的在唱诵 Krishna 的荣耀，让其他人传播 Krishna 的荣耀。
And they know Krishna is none different from the super soul in the hearts of all the living entities, and he's the actual worshipable Lord of everyone.
他们深知 Krishna 就是众生的心中的超灵。是每个人真正值得崇拜的对象。
So just like the Vaishnava may surrender everything to Krishna and give up everything just to go and serve him in out of love, so the bees in Vrindavan have the same mood. They give up everything just to serve Krishna.
就好像 Vaishnava 会臣服一切。放弃一切去服务 Krishna， 同样的，这蜜蜂们也拥有同样的心态，他们臣服一切，放弃一切去服务了 Krishna。
So now the after glorifying the bees, the gopis are going to glorify some of the different birds who live on the lake there in Vrindavan. Birds like the crane and the swan and other birds.
在荣耀完，温达文的蜜蜂之后，勾皮们开始荣耀温达文的这些鸟类，居住在湖中的鸟类，比如说仙鹤和天鹅。
So these birds, when they they come close to Krishna, they will close their eyes and they'll be very silent and they will worship him by fixing their consciousness upon him in meditation. So the gopis, they sing these songs, they help to console each other when they feel separation from Krishna during the daytime. They will sing about these different things, about the birds in Vrindavan and how they're also devotees. So these birds of Vrindavan, they're better, they're more advanced than the insects and the bugs and the bees. But even among different birds, there's different levels of Krishna consciousness. Some birds are more advanced than others. Because there's one type of bird, it's called the waterfowl. Waterfowl. And so it's not so fortunate, this bird, because he doesn't have the opportunity to get close to Krishna.
Waterfowl.
Fowl. Fowl. Waterfowl. Just say a bird. There's just a bird. Just say it's a special bird.
Okay.
So this waterfowl, he lives in a faraway lake where there's very clean water and many lotuses and many other attractions. And there's many, many birds there. There's swans and cranes and many other birds. They all come to that lake and they play there. But when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute, then their minds are captivated. So when they hear the sound of the flute, they become bewildered and they fly about like they're mad. They fly in all kinds of directions. And then they come back to the lake and then they settle down peacefully and they begin to worship Krishna. Yeah, they fix their attention only on him. They fully concentrate their attention on him and they control their minds and their senses and bodies and speech. And they close their eyes and they become very silent. They bring all their senses, their mind and their sight and speech, they bring them all under very strict control.
他们的感官、他们的心意、他们的视域，还有他们的言语，他们都严格的加以控制。
And they will leave the lake to come to sit near to Krishna.
他们也会离开他们自己所待的湖泊，然后坐在 Krishna 的附近。
Now, when they're near to Krishna, that's their greatest pleasure. And they become so peaceful, and they close their eyes and stay silent. So the birds approach Krishna, and apparently they calm down, but their minds were actually not peaceful.
这些鸟类它们接近 Krishna， 表面上它们很平静，但是它们内心并不平静。
Because the birds could not control their minds, they could not close their eyes, and they could not be silent. Because they were meditating on Krishna, so their ecstasy, it wouldn't allow them to keep their minds calm, because they were in so much ecstasy, their minds were all over the place. And they were in such anxiety because they were not able to see Krishna, they couldn't close their eyes. And their eyes even lost the ability to blink. They couldn't blink anymore. And instead they did Sankirtan, they chanted the holy names of Krishna so loudly that there was no trace of soberness. It was so ecstatic. They were wild with ecstasy. And as a result of worshipping Krishna by meditating on him, they got so much ecstasy, they even lost their consciousness.
作为崇拜 Krishna, 冥想 Krishna 的结果，他们陷入了狂喜，以至于甚至失去了知觉。
And sometimes they just simply closed their eyes and they fell silent.
有时候他们只是闭上眼睛，保持着沉默。
So although these birds are members of different species of life, although they live in the sky, and they are males, and though they live in a lake far away where they're busy enjoying, still the song of Krishna's flute has dragged them into Krishna's association.
虽然他们是属于飞禽类，属于生物， 当中的一种物种，他们的领域在天空，他们居住在遥远的湖泊，他们在忙着享受，但是 Krishna 的鼻音却吸引他们进入 Krishna 的涟漪。
So concentrating their minds on Krishna has awakened in the birds ecstatic love for Krishna. And although naturally these birds are usually peaceful and thoughtful, but because of their love for Krishna, they become ecstatic and they become very emotional. So they become completely bewildered. What to do?So what can we say about the gopis? Because the gopis have no other purpose in life than to serve Krishna. So they too they must also be suffering. But more, even more than these birds. So in the forest of Vrindavan, all the birds, they fly up into the higher branches of the trees so that they're able to see Krishna. And they close their eyes and they simply listen to the sweet sound of Krishna's flute. They're not attracted by any other sound. So we can understand these birds are on the same level as great sages.So one gopi is singing this song to Mother Yashoda, or she's singing it to another gopi because she could hear the sound of Krishna's flute. So she's singing this song.
对另外一位牧牛姑娘所唱诵的歌曲，因为她听到了 Krishna 的鼻音，所以便吟出了这样的动听的诗歌。
So these birds are very fortunate. They're living in the same trees that give shelter to Krishna. They give shade to Krishna when Krishna is wandering through the Vrindavan forest.
一些鸟类呢，他们是特别幸运的，因为他们盘踞的枝头是同样的给予了 Krishna 树荫庇护的那些同样的树木，当 Krishna 在森林当中漫游的时候。
So all the birds in Vrindavan, we should understand that they are great sages.
可以明白 Vrindavan 的所有的飞禽全部是伟大的圣者。
The sages are, there's not very many sages in Vrindavan, but there are many birds there. So these birds, they're also sages. And these birds, they hear the song of Krishna's flute when Krishna plays for the enjoyment of the cows and the cowherd boys. and the gopis of Vrindavan. So even when the birds may not hear this, the bird, like Krishna may be far away, so the birds may not hear the sound of Krishna's flute very clearly, but still the effect of the flute will be on them. When they hear the sound of Krishna's flute, then they get the vision of Krishna also. They actually have a vision of Krishna, and it brings them to the tops of the trees. They go up to the top of the trees, and then Krishna is able to see them. Actually, only Krishna can make up such beautiful music, and it comes from Krishna, and it's the sound of the flute which creates the opportunity for the birds to understand, to see Krishna by hearing.
事实上，只有 Krishna 才能谱写出、吹奏出这么美丽动听的音乐，它们是来自 Krishna 的，所以这些鼻音呢，就给了这些飞禽们一个机会去明白 Krishna， 能够去看见 Krishna。
It's not easy for them to see Krishna. It's not easy to see Krishna through all the trees and the different branches and things in the forest, but they can hear the sound of Krishna, and in this way they can understand Krishna's presence. There are many leaves and branches growing on the trees, make it very difficult for the birds to see Krishna.
有很多枝枝丫丫的，所以这些飞禽们很难去透过树叶看见Krishna。But
Krishna is also attracted. He likes to pick these different leaves and fruits and flowers from the trees.
Krishna也被吸引了，所以他会采集这树上的花朵、嫩枝、嫩叶。So
the birds, they fly up to the top branches on the trees where the leaves and the twigs don't block the vision, and they can see Krishna better. And so the birds go up to the top of the trees and they close their eyes in meditation, and they appear like great sages. Just like great sages, they want to devote themselves to Krishna, and they will find some branch of the Vedas. The Vedas is like a tree, and they will find some branch in the Vedas where they can devote themselves to Krishna.
美达金，就好像是树枝，有很多树枝一样，美达金有的很多的分支，对于这些圣者们，他们会寻找到一些美达金的分支，好让自己全身心的冥想 Krishna。
And then there will be different, the sages learn from the Vedas how to understand Krishna, and they can realize their practice, they can understand Krishna, and they can realize by their practice how to the sages learn from the Vedas how to approach Krishna, and they get from the Vedas, they get the proper discipline which they have to follow to approach Krishna. They have to offer the results of their work to Krishna. And when they're studying the Vedas, they will often be thinking about it and trying to understand what the Vedas mean. So, but at that time, the sages also become attracted to hear about Krishna's, when they hear Krishna's flute, and they become eager to see Krishna. Yeah, they give up their studies. They give up their attachment to their education, and instead they become attached to seeing Krishna. And they dedicate themselves to Krishna's, to chanting the holy names of Krishna. All right, so we will stop here.
好，接下来我们回答问题。第一个问题是来自于毛毛，亲爱的 Guru Day， 有一次听您讲课录音，听讲一个故事，灵性导师安排门徒去看守稻田，门徒很久没有回来，灵性导师去查看，原来稻田有个缺口，水流出来，门徒便挡在那缺口里堵住水流。门徒执行灵性导师的命令，看守稻田。那么，是否也可以用石块泥土堵住缺口？这样是不是也是执行灵性导师的命令？哪个更完美？Dear Gurudev, one time I heard a recording of your lecture. You said that once the spiritual master arranged his disciple to look after the field, but for a long time the disciple hasn't returned. Therefore, the spiritual master went to search for the disciple and found out that the disciple had laid down because there is a gap
in the field.
So the question is that whether because the disciple trying to carry out the order of the spiritual master, but the disciple can also use the stones, the mud to make up the gap. In this way, we'll also to carry out the order of the spiritual master. So which way is better, to use for his own body or to use stones and those mud?
Well, we don't know the situation. There may not have been stones, or there may not have been enough mud for him to fill the hole, and there was no alternative but to use his own body. So if you can use stones and mud, it's better. But if you cannot, then you may have to use your own body.
我们也不知道当时具体的情况是如何的，也许是找不到石头和足够那么多的泥土来堵住缺口，别无选择，只能用自己的身体来挡住这个缺口。This
pastime is actually in the Mahabharata, and it comes at the beginning of the Mahabharata, and it's showing the importance of surrendering to the spiritual master and dedicating oneself to the service of the Guru.
The next one, continue. Bharat Wang 迷恋了小鹿，但看到小鹿处在危险，不救他吗？如果不救小鹿，他就没有机会迷恋小鹿了。我们该如何避免阿拉特王的情况呢？阿拉特玛拉什 became attracted to a little deer, but if he didn't save the little deer, there is no chance of being involved in attachment of the little deer. But the little deer is in danger. So how can we avoid the situation, the same situation as that of the Bharat Maharaj?
Well, we can avoid that by having good association. The good association will help us from getting too much affectionate to the deer. It was all right that Bharat Maharaj saved the deer, but the problem was he became too much affectionate to the deer, and then he gave up his own spiritual practice.
我们可以通过良好的联谊来避免Bharat Maharaj、Bharat Wang的这种同样情况，这可以帮助我们不至于过度的依恋一个事物。Bharat Wang救这头小鹿，这是正确的。但是问题在于他过度的依恋、爱恋这头小鹿了，
yeah, we may,
以至于他忽视了自己的灵修。
We may not have a deer, but we may have other things like a deer. For example, we have a motor car, or we have a grandchild, and we become very affectionate to them, and we spend a lot of time, and they take us away from our spiritual practice.
我们的情况可能不是针对一头小鹿，也许我们是有一辆摩托车，或者是我们有自己的孙辈、孙子、孙女，然后我们特别爱他们，所以他就占用了很多时间，以至于忽视了自己的灵修了。
So we have to be very careful, because attachments to material things will certainly take us away from our spiritual practice.
要小心的是，我们对物质事物的依恋可能会把我们从灵修的路途上外跑偏离。
So if Bharat had an association, somebody would have been there to warn him that, you know, this deer is interfering with your meditation, with your spiritual practice. It's not good.
If 旁边的同修就会警告他，一头小鹿已经干涉到他的冥想，影响到他自己的灵修了。
Yeah, sometimes people think about changing their ashram, going into another ashram, like going into Grihastha ashram, but they don't understand that it's going to be very difficult for their spiritual practice.
有的时候呢，有个人们会想考虑换一下自己的就是灵性进阶，想换一个另外一个灵性的进阶，想进入居士阶层，但是他们并不明白居士阶层的困难之处。
OK。
下一个问题，菩提果，Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru。Hare Krishna， 顶拜 Guru。在这个年代回归神手，在这个年代靠念诵圣名，临终时意念或者念诵至尊主，亲眼见到四比维什奴，能临终回文达文洛克还是维什奴洛克？尊敬的马拉，如果您愿意成为小蝴蝶或把哈瑞克什纳，哈瑞克什纳 with guru in this age we depend on chanting the holy name and at the time of the final moment, remember the Supreme Lord. The question is that if we can see the forearm of Vishnu by our own eye, can we go back to Goloka Vrindavan or to Vishnu Loka?
It's more likely you will go to Vaikuntha, not to Goloka, because if you're seeing the four-armed Vishnu, that is the form which is in Vaikuntha.
很有可能那会回到 Vaikuntha， 如果见到的是四臂的 Vishnu 形象的话，那是回到目的地是 Vaikuntha 而不是 Goloka。
Yes.
Next one from Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada. Some devotees say it is very difficult for them to accept Lord Chaitanya as the Supreme Personality of God. They can only accept him as a pure Krishna devotee. What advice is there for such devotees? 这个问题是来自于 Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj.接受卑微礼拜，荣耀归于菩萨。有些奉献者说，他们很难接受卢柴丹尼亚是自尊性格神手，他们只能接受卢柴丹尼亚是主昆士的纯粹奉献者。对此，您有什么建议？对这样的奉献者
？All right, if you accept him as a great devotee, then follow his instructions, chant Hare Krishna, and surrender to Krishna.
没问题，如果他们接受卢柴丹尼亚是伟大的奉献者的话，那么就去服从卢柴丹尼亚的训示，唱诵 Hare Krishna， 臣服 Krishna 就好了。
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu comes in the mood of a devotee, so you're seeing him in the mood which he's presenting to the world. He's presenting himself as a devotee. He's not presenting himself as the Supreme Lord.
天天马哈帕布是以奉献者的身份降临的，而且他的心态是一个奉献者的心态，所以他把自己呈现给世人的是奉献者的身份和奉献的人心态，而不是尊主的身份。
So, but you have to follow his instructions.
关键是得要服从他的训示。The next one from us. 圣地所有动物都不是普通生物吗？ All the living entities, all the animals in the holy dung, they are they are not ordinary living entity, right?
Right.
是的，圣地动物都不是普通生物。
They're great devotees.
他们全都是伟大的奉献者。
To take birth in the holy dham, even as a blade of grass or a creeper plant, it's a special birth.
在圣地，即便投生为一片草、一个爬藤和植物，那都是。特殊的投生。
And Lord Brahma also prayed that he could take birth like that in Vrindavan.
就连主 Brahma 也祈祷他能够在 Vrindavan 有这样的出生机会。
Mm-hmm.
下一个 Shruti Rupa Devadasi Hare Krishna 顶拜咕噜老师们，今天有几个问题。一，在奉爱的学习当中，朋友们说我放下很多面子虚荣，发自内心愿意帮助别人，但是我仍然还是习惯在内心评判抗拒一些不喜欢的人和事物。请问 Guru 该如何训练自己稳稳当当的不再完全的臣服于奉爱的状态呢？ Hare Krishna, listen to the Guru and teachers. So the first question is that during the period of this Bhakti Yoga practice,My friends commented that I have given up many false prestige and things like to save face like that, but, and I would voluntarily from my heart wish to help others. Yet still in my heart I'm habituated to judge and to reject, to rebel something and somebody who I don't like. So, Guru, how can I train myself to be steadily situated in the situation that I can completely surrender and have the devotion?
Well, it takes practice. You have to be patient.You haven't been practicing devotional service very long, but as you go on with your practice, gradually, you'll become purified. And with that purification, then you'll come to that level that you'll be able to be equal to everyone.
那这是需要练习的，您要有耐心，因为您练奉爱瑜伽还时间不长，所以您需要继续去练习，获得进化，能达到来到这个层面，能够有平等的赐予，平等对待众生。
Devotional service is the process, so you're on the process. As you go through the different stages of devotion.Gradually, you'll come to the stage where you have to remove. Now even you may be at this stage where you're trying to remove the unwanted things from the heart. So this is the most challenging, this is the most difficult of the stages of devotion. And you have to do it by very carefully hearing and chanting.
奉献服务它有一个递进的阶段，有不同的层面，有一个层面就是努力的去去除内心不需要的多余的这些污染，那个阶段呢是最具有挑战性的，这是最难的一个阶段。所以你要去做的呢就是小心翼翼的去聆听唱诵。
You have to improve the quality of your devotional service. Your own sadhana has to become better.
您需要去努力地提升自己做奉爱服务的品质。您的规范修习 sadhana 需要过得更好。
And with better sadhana, then all the good qualities will manifest in you.
随着 sadhana 规范修行的品质的提高，您身上的优秀品质就会闪现出来。
So constant practice and detachment is also important. Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, Arjuna was telling Krishna that he couldn't control his mind. But Krishna said, yes, I know it's difficult, but you can do it by practice and detachment. So these two things are also required in your position. Constant practice and detachment.
Arjuna 告诉 Krishna 是要控制心意，是特别难的。所以 Krishna 就告诉 Arjuna 说：“我知道，但是呢，修习和气绝，是需要恒常的修习，以及需要有气绝。所以对于您这种情况来说，就是需要恒常的去修行，坚持不懈的修习以及气绝，这两个方面。
嗯
哼。下一个第二个问题，这段时间，这段时间就是很多病人、抑郁症患者或者失去亲人的人，他们都深陷当下的痛苦中。在聆听了一段时间的佛家梵歌后，他们提问：怎样才能获得 Krishna 的仁慈？快速从痛苦中解脱出来呢？ During this period of time, I got contact with many patients and many people who had got the illness of depression and also people who had lost their dearmost one. So after listening to Bhagavad Gita for a certain period of time, it raised the question that how can they got the mercy at the mercy of Lord Krishna and get rid of this painfulness quickly.
Which painfulness?
Somebody has a serious illness. There are three kind of persons that Shruti Rupa Mataji has got contact. Somebody who has got a serious illness, and somebody who is in depression, and somebody who has lost their relatives.
So she wants to know how can they get rid of their pain.
And they listen to Bhagavad Gita for some time, and after that they wondered how can they get rid of the pain and get the mercy of Lord Krishna.
Well, they have to chant. They have to also chant themselves. They have to chant regularly. They have to follow the process of Krishna consciousness. Then they can get the mercy. Yes, the material world is a painful place. So we have to want to get out of this material world. We should be thinking about how to get free from material life, how to get beyond birth and death. So first thing is they have to understand we're not the body. But we are simply living in a body. And we identify with the body. We're attached to the body. So we have to understand this is ignorance, this is our disease, this is the cause of our pain.
We're not 这个躯体，而且我们必定依附于这个躯体，这是我们的愚昧，这是我们的疾病，也是我们痛苦的根源。Next one. 下一个问题是来自于 Shama Hare Krishna Dimapur Mar 所有奉献者，请问 Guru， Daksha 诅咒了 Narada， 因为自尊主命令他繁衍人口，但是 Narada 却希望 Daksha 的后代能回归守神，当两种权威的姓氏互相冲突时该怎么办呢？ Shama ask that the obeisance Guru Maharaj and all devotees. My question is that Daksha cursed Narada Muni because the Supreme Lord ordered him to create progeny. Yet Narada hopes that the descendant of Daksha can go back to Godhead. So my question is that when there are conflict between the instructions of two authorities, what should we do?
Well, you should consider what's the higher purpose, what's more important. Certainly, if Daksha can go back to Godhead, he should go back to Godhead. But if he's not able to go back to Godhead, then at least let him do some service for the Lord in the material world and produce progeny.
你要考虑哪个是更高的目标，哪一个更重要。如果Daksha本人他能回归神手，那是很好的。但是如果他不能的话，那么他就在物质世界服务主，去繁衍后代。
There's always somebody else can produce the progeny. Some other people can do that. There will always be other people. But if there's the opportunity to go back to Godhead, then they go back to Godhead, then they can immediately engage in direct service to the pleasure of Krishna. We don't go back to Godhead just for our own pleasure. We go back to Godhead for the pleasure of Krishna, to please Krishna.
总会有别的人能够在物质世界繁衍后代的。但是如果能回归神手的话，就可以回到灵智世界，立刻的直接的来服务，来为了取悦 Krishna 来做服务，能让 Krishna 快乐，取悦 Krishna。
So going back to Godhead is not wrong. That's the highest. It's the highest thing we can do.
回归神手没有错误，而且回归神手是，是最高的目标。
The Supreme Lord is not going to mind if Daksha goes back to Godhead. He won't mind. He can always get somebody else to do to create progeny.
如果我们回归了神手，至尊主不会介意的，他会让别人来繁衍后代的。
Yes.
下一个来自于 Yukita Sharma. Hare Krishna, Gurudev Panhal, all glory to Srila Prabhupada, your Gurudev, and devotees of the Lord. Gurudev, the sages have taken the form of beasts to serve Lord Krishna in Vrindavan. Are we all practicing now to get forms of animals, or worms, or such beings, or mantaries in Vrindavan?这个问题是由 Peter Sharma 的 Hare Krishna Gurudev， 荣耀归于Srila Prabhupada， 对您，在Vrindavan的那些蜜蜂们，他们本来是圣者们，但是他们却变成蜜蜂的形象来服务主 Krishna。 我们现在修行是不是也是准备去得到Vrindavan的动物的形象，或者是蠕虫的形象，或者是 mandarin 的形象呢？
Well, you should understand in the spiritual world, in Goloka Vrindavan, all different species of life are there. There are bees and insects and worms. They're all there and they're pure devotees. And pure devotees take these forms
just for the service of Krishna. These different species of life, the living entities, the pure devotees, they can assume these forms, but they don't have to stay in that form forever. They can change their forms, they can take different forms as they like for the service of Krishna. You're trying to understand the spiritual world with your conditioning of the material world, but you have to appreciate this is the spiritual world. You can't understand it with your material mind and senses.
您现在呢是在用就是物质世界的受条件限制的这种心意和感官来去理解灵性的世界，但这是做不到的。
You're thinking of bees. As you think of bees, you're thinking of bees as you know them. But the bees in Vrindavan, they're very special. This Vrindavan is the spiritual world. So these bees are not ordinary living entities.
您现在就是在用您所了解的这个蜜蜂的这种状态去理解灵性世界的蜜蜂，但是这些蜜蜂是温达文的蜜蜂。
他们都是各殊的，他们不是普通的生物。OK。下一个问题是来自于晨晨。Hare
Krishna, my guru, 请问什么是纯粹的分外服务？还在家庭生活中，家庭的职责和分外服务如何链接呢？ Mm-hmm. Ask Hare Krishna, this is Guru, and the question is, what is pure devotional service?
Yes.
Because I'm still in family life, I have family duties, how can I connect them with devotional service?
Yes, in any position of life, we can connect our duties to devotional service.
我们可以在生命的任何状态下都跟奉献服务连接在一起。
We have to understand everything in relation to Krishna. So you're in family life, and so your family are also part and parcel of Krishna. And your home and your properties, they are also Krishna's properties, given to you by the grace of Krishna. You should use them for the service of Krishna. So pure devotional service means to serve Krishna constantly and favorably. Constantly means every day, and everything you do should be done for Krishna. And when we speak of Krishna, we don't just mean only Krishna, Vrindavan, but also Krishna's expansions or Krishna's energies and Krishna's paraphernalia, and Krishna's devotees. So pure devotional service is to recognize that everything that we see, it belongs to Krishna, it's for his service, and we're his servants. We're meant to be the servant of Krishna, but we have to serve Krishna in a manner which is pleasing to him. Not just pleasing to us, but pleasing to him. So we serve Krishna without any desire, without any expectation of having anything given to us in return. We don't even ask Krishna for liberation. That is pure devotion. If we are worshipping Krishna, but in our heart we're thinking, Krishna, give me the good companion, give me the good job, give me the child, that this is not pure devotion.
如果我们外在的崇拜 Krishna， 内心呢却暗暗的想着， Krishna 给我一个好的伴侣吧， Krishna 给我一份好工作吧， Krishna 给我一些好的孩子吧， 这个就不是纯粹的奉爱服务了。
Yes，
下一个是 Harini， 顶拜 Gurudev， 一切荣耀归于圣帕帕的根灵， Krishna Priya。 请问温达文的爬虫和树木是不是还要在温达文投生一次的那些灵魂才能回到 Krishna Lokan？ 感谢 Gurudev 的回答。 So this question is from Harini's mother, Vrindavan Priya. Those insects in Vrindavan and those trees in Vrindavan, won't they take birth again? In Vrindavan again, they can return to Krishna Loka?
Yes, they'll go back to Krishna Loka. Actually, they're already in Gokula. Vrindavan on earth is Gokul. And after this life, the next birth, they'll go to Goloka.
She asked that those trees and worms in Vrindavan, are they going to take, after they leave this present body, and they will take birth again in Gokula in Vrindavan, and then after that they can go back to Krishna Loka?
Well, it depends on Krishna. If Krishna wants them, they may go directly back to Goloka. If Krishna wants them back in Goloka, they'll go back to Goloka. If he wants them to stay and take birth again, they may take birth again. It's up to Krishna. Right.
The next part of the question is that 还有在温达文投生的那些动物和植物都是来自于哪里投生的灵魂？ So about those animals and plants in Vrindavan. So the souls of these animals and plants, where do they come from?
Well, they're living entities just like us, and maybe they've taken birth many times in different bodies, and gradually they've become elevated to the platform of devotional service. So they take birth in Vrindavan.
他们都是像我们一样的生物体，他们在不同的身体当中投生了许许多多次，然后最后他们提升到了奉献服务的层面上，最后他们投生到了Vrindavan。
They're not ordinary living entities, but they've been ordinary living entities, but by devotional service they've become elevated to that platform.
他们原本是普通的生物，但是由于做奉献服务，他们就提升到了这样的层面上了。
In the past, we have also had so many different bodies. We've also been bees and worms, but not in Vrindavan.
我们在过往的生世当中也曾经做过蜜蜂，做过那些蠕虫。
Now we have the human form of life. Now we have the opportunity to become Krishna conscious.
现在我们有了这个人类的躯体，现在我们有机会能具有 Krishna 直觉。
We have to take advantage of this opportunity. And then, next life, we may take birth in Vrindavan.
所以我们要善加利用这个机会。
See, this may be their final birth before going back to Godhead, because they're taking birth as bees, but Krishna's there in Vrindavan, so they're able to directly associate with Krishna, to follow Krishna, even though they're in the body of bees, but they get a lot of purification and instruction by being near to Krishna.
那些，文达们的蜜蜂们，因为Krishna临在于文达们，所以他们就有机会能够直接跟Krishna联谊，并且追随Krishna，这样他们就得到了大量的净化。
Now, Prabhupada said one time, he said that the pigs in Vrindavan, he said they were yogis who committed some offense and they had to take birth as pigs for one life, and next life they would go back to Godhead.
他们是做了冒犯的瑜伽师，所以他们必须要有一世投生在本大本，投生为猪。那么在下一世结束了这个猪的躯体之后，他们下一世就回到神首身边了。Okay,
next question.
Okay, so that's finished.
Finished?
Yes.
Oh, wonderful.
Krishna Kumar, 是吧?
It's
only a comment, right? 没有了吧？问题？没有的。嗯。Finished. Okay. So, Vamagansha Gurumani Givamajantai Defunti, Vamagansha Sayuda Functions of LinkedIn, Vamajufuniman, Waisi Jinkan, Shangho Kwaila, Wanshit Rui, Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Oh, by Kunta Jin Fu Yang Ting, Umfei Chang Dan Xie, Bhakti Vaishnava Singha.